Hello and welcome back to the Harrier Project. This is a big update today because the second prototype is printed and there are so many new things that I want to tell you. Okay, I want to show you the differences between the first prototype that was flown 2 weeks before. Yeah, here you can see a link to the video and the next prototype. This time we wanna go VTOL, yeah, and we wanna put a lot of more technique into this Harrier. This is one reason why we made the fuselage 10% bigger, yeah. So there is more place for the leveling board, for the gears, and more electronics. So I would say, let's start from the nose to see what is new on the second prototype. Yeah, as you can see, there is a big hole. This is for the front EDF. Yeah, we will use altogether minimum 5 EDFs for leveling. Yeah, 2 on the wings, and 2 on the fuselage, and 1 on the rear fuselage for yaw. Yeah, and in this hole we can easily put at the moment. We think about this 40 millimeter EDF. We can easily put it in and see how it works and also easily remove it. Yeah. So, and then we can see here in this first fuselage section, this time we want to install a gear, yeah, a complete retractable landing gear. So everything is prepared for easy installing. Then the inlet section is modified, yeah, so we have a bigger distance in here to get more air for the EDF into it. For us, it's always very important to get maximum thrust, and for maximum thrust, we need a good airflow. And also we included in this section the inlet ring, yeah, so it is much more easy to install the whole EDF, yeah, because you can see here, with the inlet ring on the EDF itself, it's not possible to install it, and you can't grab easily in here. So now you just have to put the EDF without the inlet ring into the section and everything is nice. Okay, let's go to the midsection. Here is a lot of things modified. Yeah? Let's start on the bottom. Here we have a big hatch for installing the ESC, yeah. We will test a lot of ESCs that you can see here to get the best performance and the most lightweight one, yeah. And hopefully this one, this is a pro shot, I think 200 amps, yeah, 200 amps ESC, that I think this should work with this EDF. This just need about 110 amps. So, but this is super lightweight and super efficient, yeah. And here, when we put this here, we got easy access. On the old version, it was just underneath this ducting about here, and this was not easy to reach. And yeah, this makes a lot of things easier. And you also can see these small holes in here, these square holes. We want to have very easy access to all the hatches, so the idea is to use a lot of magnets, small magnets, and into this square holes here, and also on the fuselage there will be put small but very strong magnets, so that this just glides something like this in here and then flip on it and it stays, yeah. And you can see here on this hatch cover, there is already the NACA inlet included. Yeah, this is for cooling the ESC. Yeah, so it doesn't have to build afterwards in it. We want to include as much as possible to make the assembly of this Harrier as easy and fast as possible. Yeah. And the most special thing on this Harrier is that it got rotatable nozzles. Yeah. And these nozzles, they will be put here, and they will be driven by a modified servo, yeah, by a gear on this nozzle. On the side, we got a gear here. This is like a big gear. And here's the second gear. and this works like this, and this will rotate the whole nozzle. Yeah, here it is already built. I will show you. So here you can see how the nozzle is rotating. This works super nice, and we can put it in every position. Yeah, and we will use altogether 4 servos. Yeah, they have to be optimized that they can rotate 360 degrees, and we have some special electronic for this. Yeah, and they will be installed also here in this midsection. Okay, let's go to the next useless section. Here you can see here is also a hole inbuilt. Yeah, this is for the rear EDF, for the two EDFs for tilting. Yeah, and this is also for easy access. Yeah, this is just for the prototype. Later on, we will hide these EDFs that it looks most as hairy as possible. Yeah, and here is also a board for the electronics, for the copter board also on. Yeah, this is super nice designed. Yeah, Sigi does absolutely amazing work on this. You can see here the gear doors. Yeah, they are already on printed. Yeah, so everything is already installed. Yeah, this is super easy. This will be super easy for assembly. Yeah, I am super happy with this result on this Harrier. On the rear, you can also see this small hatch for the magnet, yeah, for the easy installation of this door, of this cover door. And there is also some specialty on the vertical stabilizer. Yeah. This time, the rudder can easily slide in to this small gap here. Yeah. Everything you can see here is printed. Yeah, just slide in, and we have a ready working rudder. Yeah, it's absolutely nice. It's so easy to assemble and super light. Yeah, and I'm looking forward to it. We also make this rudder a little bit bigger. Yeah, for better control at very slow speed, for making the transition smooth and easy. Yeah. Okay, I would say let's go to the wings. On the wings, we also had these holes for assembling the EDFs. We will start with 30 millimeter EDFs and maybe go a little bit bigger for best hovering efficiency. On the wings itself, this time these vortex generators that works best are already included. So this is one thing printed. The ailerons are completely printed as elastic flaps. Yeah? So there is nothing to glue or something like this. Yeah. This time we got also flaps. The flaps will be coupled with the rotatable nozzles to slow down and have a smooth transition and for good and efficient hovering. And the best thing, or one of the best things, is so much, is here really nice, is that this second prototype weighs about 250 gram less than the first prototype. Yeah, even with a bigger fuselage and much more parts inbuilt. Yeah, this was about 1050 grams, and now we are at exactly 800 grams for this whole airplane, and it is still super stable and it will fly absolutely amazing. I'm really looking forward to it, but now there is a lot of work to do. Yeah, we have to check out which are the best EDFs for stabilization, also which ESCs work best. Yeah, then we look for FC, yeah, that control all the leveling, and all this will be tested in the next video. So if you like these videos and you want to see more of them, you can support this channel by becoming a Patreon or buy me a coffee or donate something via PayPal. Yeah, the links are underneath in the description. And yes, I would say see you in the next video. Bye bye.